Hello once again, YouTube. Chris the Nightbringer here, bringing you StarMade Stable Build 0.18999. And my god, it is one hell of an update. As you can see, I've activated via my recording button one of the new menus to look at in StarMade. If you hit F12, apparently you can bring up a network stats window, which will tell you all sorts of information about networking and receiving and sent bits of information. I have no idea what I am personally sending or receiving from because I'm playing on single player. Maybe it's just talking about the local host and stuff. I have no idea. But if you're interested in that kind of things, those kind of things, you can press F12 and look at the network stats window. Now, aside from that little feature that I only just discovered while recording, there are tons of optimizations to the game, graphically as well as in terms of network performance. Graphically, players should be experiencing an FPS increase of up to twice as much as they had before. So, you know, it's just better to look at larger things now, and you should all do that because it's pretty awesome. Of course, with every update comes its batch of bugs that have been overlooked, but that being said, so far what we are experiencing is working pretty well. I'm already hearing lots of good things from the new, recent, or soon to be opened, Shattered Skies server. I don't know if it's opened at this point. They're working on it right now, but definitely check that out. Link in the description. I'm already hearing lots of good things from players on servers about how well everything is working, how much of a performance boost these people are receiving, and it's really great. Just a heads up, and from what I've read on the dev blog, in order to get in on the performance boosts, you have to turn off occlusion culling, which you can do from in-game as well as out-of-game. So, there are some new blocks real quick that I would like to share with you. There's only three new blocks, but here is one of them. This is the Forcefield. It acts just like a regular door. You can activate it with a core logic as well as touching it with your hand, pressing R of course, and it comes in three colors, yellow, blue, and red, and this is quite amazing. I have no doubt further functionality will be added to the Forcefields, so stay tuned and pay attention to that. In the future you may be seeing additional functions such as harming enemy faction members when passing through it or touching it, or being able to fly ships through it while it prevents players from flying through it or something. I don't know, there's all sorts of crazy things they could do, and it's pretty awesome. But there it is, that is the yellow force field. As you could tell, the texture is slightly animated, and you can't really see it from over here, but there you go. Hopefully you guys can see that. If we come inside real quick, I'll show you the blue one, which is right here. Again, a slightly animated texture. It kind of pulses brighter, and it's got like a nice little pattern on it. And then the red one is over here. It's got a very basic grid layout. It's kind of hard to see because it's oversaturating the area, the rest of the blocks behind it. But there you have it. That is the three new force field blocks, which is pretty sweet. So I'm going to jump out of this ship, and I'm going to jump into the Executioner, which is one of my other ships. One major thing that has changed is that shields or shield capacitors have been buffed. They now can carry twice as much shielding in one block. So the previous value, I believe, was 55, and now they can carry 110 shields per shield capacitor. So in terms of what I do and the way I build my ships, that's pretty awesome because my ships now have more survivability to them. Shields were, you know, not really gonna work compared to how much hull I was putting on these ships and how little my weapon systems are. But now shields are actually, you know, kind of buffed. This is to prevent alpha damage, apparently. I personally have absolutely no idea what effect this will have when weapons and hull and health updates come out in the future. Or if, you know, tweaks to values and stuff will, you know, have an effect on how this all plays out in the end. Personally, I thought that shields were not something that needed to be altered. I thought, you know, hull was the primary concern, but I'm not gonna say anything about it. I think it's actually kind of neat. It kind of works with the stuff that I do, so that's pretty sweet. And, you know, I know a lot of players that wanted that suggestion followed through are now probably happy about it. I am going to jump into this ship right now. And let's see. Okay, power supply. Power supply has been buffed. It should be more noticeably effective than it was before. If we look at that ship there, you could see that it has 0.0% power out of 568,000 power capacity. I took out all the power reactors and reset the power capacity on the Dragoon. And so if we start firing this power supply beam, which for the first time I can actually see, we should see power increase. Now, of course, the shielding on the Dragoon is sucking that power right up. So once the shielding reaches 100%, we should see the power slowly increase. Hopefully that happens in the next burst. So, real quick, just so you know how many blocks I am using, for every system on here, master or slave, there will be 38 blocks attached to it. For the power supply beam, I have 30 power supply beam modules attached to it, and 30 power supply beam modules is capable of giving about 3%, 4%, maybe even 5% of 568,000 power capacity. So personally, I've noticed the increase because I tried using power capacity or power supply before, and it definitely looks like it's been boosted. And it would definitely, hopefully, become more of a viable option for some ships because it's something I don't see there often. That being said, let's move on. Real quick, I have to add some warheads to the front of my ship. They have been renamed warheads, if you did not know. I'm putting them as far out as I possibly can because I already, as you could tell, damaged the core with some warheads a few moments ago. We are going to use this warhead against some armor. Now, real quick actually, let's break this up into three. Hopefully those won't blow each other up. And we're just gonna knock the right warhead into regular hull. Look at that damage. That is some massive damage from warheads, and suddenly these things have become a lot more valuable in terms of combat. That is crazy. Warheads never used to do this much damage. Apparently the block damage is twice as much now. Personally, that looks like it's five times as much, because when I used to mess around with warheads, they would break two, maybe three blocks at a time. Standard or advanced, it didn't really matter. They hardly penetrated anything that I bumped them up against, and now they are just doing crazy damage. I mean, look how much advanced hull, or advanced armor, this one warhead took out. Grouping them up does not seem to increase the amount of damage they throw out there. I tested this before. Like I said, grouping them up doesn't seem to increase any damage. At least I didn't notice it. Perhaps it does, but it seems to be just based off of how close the explosion is to the armor for each individual block. Grouping them does not do anything special. So, what else is there? Real quick, faction permission changes. Apparently there are all sorts of new faction permission changes that you can assign to individual members or ranks of your faction. So people are asked to check that out and make sure that everything is updated so that they are not losing stuff or having things become a problem because of their faction permissions. Character starter gear, which includes credits, blocks, meta items, and blueprints. When you set up a server, you can now make it so that each new player on the server starts with a specific amount of credits, specific blocks, specific meta items, and specific blueprints, and those blueprints can be filled or unfilled. There is apparently files to go look into in order to set this up, so I highly suggest you look into that if you care about that or if you're a server owner. Of course, you can find out more information about all this stuff in the dev blog, which I will post a link to in the description below, so please be sure to check that out if you want more information. There's tons of stuff about the optimization, by the way, that's been posted there. Changes to all the armors and hulls. Normal hull now have 75 health points. Standard armor has 100 health points and 60 armor. Advanced armor has 250 health points and 75 armor. They have been buffed. And this is due to the upcoming health system, apparently. On top of that, anything that is expensive, such as systems, very specifically systems, computers, modules, things like that, have also had an increase to their health, although there are so many blocks in those individual categories that we are not going to list all those values here, but it has been mentioned that a lot of health buffing has been going on with all sorts of those important and expensive systems. Of course, shields have been doubled, power supply has been improved, and warheads do double block damage. So that's all stuff I've gone over. There have been changes to missile pulse and missile beam combinations. Missile pulse, the radius has been nerfed, but they are slightly faster and they do more damage. The missile beam... crap, what does the missile beam say? Oh, it's slower. The missile beam, I didn't write anything down, I'm an idiot. Missile beam is slower, so anti-missile turrets have less of a chance of missing it. So, real quick, we're gonna fire off the missile pulse just to see how much a missile with 30 modules and a pulse system slave to it with 30 modules, that should be 100% effect, 30 by 30, that we'll see how much damage it does, this missile pulse. So we're gonna shoot. That's not bad. That's actually really nice. That is, of course, being shot at water. So I don't really think this has any armor value or any of that stuff going on. That's 30 blocks for each. And that's this system right here going down 30 blocks. We're real quick going to shoot the missile beam. We're going to do it in this quadrant right here. Alright, so let's see. It does look... real quick, we can check... 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So that's a 7 radius. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So both of those weapons have done a radius of 7. Now, of course, I am shooting at water, so I have absolutely no idea. Those are two individual systems. We're going to wait for them to reload, and we will shoot them at the armor up here in a moment. Until they have both reloaded, we're going to move on and do some stuff with the other systems. So let's see. What else has changed, you might be asking? Let's take a look. Piercing effect. Damage applied gets halved, then continues onto the next block. There is a soft cap at 7 blocks, and it can potentially destroy blocks underneath armor but just before destroying the armor itself. So piercing effect quite literally does what it's supposed to now. Or at least it. I'm hoping that it does. Basically, you'll be able to pierce armor and destroy systems or other weaker blocks underneath the armor before actually destroying the armor itself. Imagine punching a hole straight through the armor and doing damage to computers or piping or anything else behind it. That's essentially what it's supposed to do. So real quick, we will demonstrate this on some of these armor blocks, as well as do a penetration test. So we have the regular hull here. We're just gonna shoot once. Oh, that was a loud bang. And again, that is a cannon system, 30 blocks with a piercing system, 30 blocks. We'll do it again up here. That didn't seem to go as far in, and the explosion was much quieter. And finally, you can see that advanced armor is really holding up. I'm not seeing any damage. I'm not even seeing broken blocks. It doesn't look like there are any broken blocks. This went one block in, and in regular hull, it did two blocks and a little bit of damage. So, that's not bad. That's not bad. Very loud explosion with the regular hull. We'll shoot once more. And again, it doesn't look like anything's really changed, two blocks. So, I mean, I'm not using a massive weapon system, I'm just demonstrating the differences and possibly what has changed. Of course, I am sure if there were systems behind this, that's something I honestly probably should have demonstrated, but it would appear as if, you know, if systems were behind this for it to damage, they would be damaged as well. Real quick, we're gonna take the beam system that I have here and connect it to the piercing system. And then we're gonna find it in here. Hopefully, there it is. So let's real quick do some beam damage. We'll do this in the other corner. That's one salvo. It's another salvo. That's the final salvo. Alright, so we'll see how much damage it does here. That's 5 blocks. I can't see the texture on that. If we go up... That's 5 blocks as well. And it's broken 2 of the advanced hull. So, hopefully that gives us an idea as to what's going on with this. Now, let's real quick look at the changes to punch through. Right? Yes? No? No. Explosive. 1/6 of damage is applied to touching blocks. Now, I have no idea if they actually changed this, but they made sure to mention it in the dev blog, so it's entirely possible that something has changed. We are going to test this out now. We're going to do a cannon with explosive effect. 30 blocks of cannon, 30 blocks of explosive. That's to advanced hull. That's standard armor. That's... No. My mistake. That's regular hull, standard armor, and advanced armor. As you can see, again, very little damage to the single advanced block. It has spread out some damage on the advanced... or the standard armor. And the regular hull, a lot more damage than the standard hull. So real quick, again, we will tie it to the beam system. And we will test it with the beam system. Damage beam computer. I'm gonna sneeze, hold on. Oh god, I didn't sneeze. Shoot. Oh, I am sorry about that. There it is on the standard hull. And the regular hull. And I can go in here real quick. I can see that the beam did about 6 blocks of damage. 5 blocks destroyed here, and 1 block destroyed there. Not bad. Not bad. So, personally, I like the explosive effect because it just applies the damage in a really nice way, although there are benefits to using punch through and piercing. Punch through. Damage applied to a block gets reduced by block effective health points, then continues. Soft cap at 7 blocks. So if you have a cannon that can do enough damage to break a block, it reduces the damage of the shot by the amount that would have been absorbed by the block, or the block's effective health points, right? And then it moves on and carries the rest of the damage that's left over up to 7 blocks into the structure. So we're going to test this now with cannons. I'm going to come over here and demonstrate it on these fresh hulls. So that was the standard hull, or the regular hull. That's advanced hull, or no. I'm getting these all mixed up. That's regular, standard, and advanced. Those were 3 shots. Very little damage there. In fact, so little damage that I didn't hear an explosion. This one did quite a bit of damage to the blocks right next to it. Let's see if we can line up a more straight shot. And actually, we'll do this as close as we can to the edge. Just so we can see that, you know, that damage is going in deeper. I don't know if it's just me or the weapons that I'm using, but these weapons don't seem to be doing as much damage as I thought they would be doing. Maybe that's just me, and maybe it's just because I'm using a single-shot weapon system, but I feel like they should be doing more damage. Look at that! Punch through. Making its effect noticeable. And actually, real quick, let's do the piercing effect in a similar fashion. Let's line it up against the side and fire it that way. I do apologize if this is a little bit long of a video. And then we've shot it there. Shot it there. So we got 3 blocks plus damage, 5 blocks no damage, and 5 blocks no additional damage, it looks like. There could be damage, but the texture may not have turned on because of how little damage would have been applied. Anyway, let's real quick use the pulse missile system on some of these blocks here. Let's do it to standard, just so we can see the damage. That's the pulse. Here's the beam. Okay, so the beam did... Okay, I should probably... I kind of messed that up by doing the beam on the advanced hull and the pulse on the standard hull. Doesn't really make sense when you think about it, but maybe I've got my point across. This is just an update video to show you all the changes that I thought were important or whatnot. Regardless, thank you for watching. That's pretty much all I have to say for this episode. I'll be doing tests like this in the future if I need to. Well, it was pretty interesting. You know, there's some new blocks, lots of optimizations, and of course this is nothing compared to the rail system that's going to be implemented, which is going to add a whole bunch of features and gameplay options to us in the future. So, thank you for watching. This was Stable Build 0.18999 of StarMade. The dev blog is below, so check that out if you so desire. Thank you for watching, subscribe for more of these videos, and I will see you all next time.